Why don't we give that a shot? Calm down. Oh, right. No. I didn't do the thing that I was trying to do. Which was this. Sure. Something did a thing down here. Oh, whatever. Okay. Let's go up here. Let's go over here. Oh, jeez. Really, though? Really? I saw the thing on the right-hand side of the screen, and I was like, what the hell? How do I do that? And then I completely flubbed getting into the actual thing that I could get into. Those corner spikes, though. What a pain. Okay, so... So I could dash into this thing and then maybe, but I don't think... maybe. And then dash up to that one, grab that, recharge. Now I'll need to use the extra... Well, wait a second. But if I do that, then... Right, okay, so I'll have to grab the side of that one. That's fine. There we go. Hooray! I'm all keyed up. Oh wait, I didn't mean to. I'm not keyed up anymore. Okay, so I can go up here. This is still locked. And I guess this is where I start and go that way. Need to unlock this to get into the other key. Okay, so there's four of these. I need to dash to reveal that one. And they all move rather fast. So... so, I mean, I could dash here. Start out with that. Try and get that one. And then the thing? This is tricky. So where do I absolutely have to dash? So as long as I can grab onto the platform on the left, then I should be able to jump over and just grab that one. And I can jump off of the one on the right to grab that, and then possibly get into the door. But I have to dash for the bottom one, and then grab onto this, and I have to dash to reveal the top one. Those corner crystals, though, dude. This down here, which I can unlock. Perfectly timed. Need to take another path to get to this one. Presumably, up here. Not at all up here. Thank you. So I'll need to use the spring, and then maybe I can catch on to the left side as it's moving along, and then get on top of it and spring up. Dash to get that to come over to me. Though, of course, I don't know how fast it's going to be moving. And then jump into that. Go on a diagonal fall. Get through there. Up. And then I have to, well, thread the needle here, I guess. And then I hit the mirror. Easy peasy. Or something. Couldn't be easier. Not the jump button, dude. Come on. Can I do better than that? I knew that was gonna screw me when I got up there. Because I was just thinking, like, I don't know how fast that platform is going to move. Instances where the telescope doesn't really help you with. Probably one of the more challenging elements of the room. With trippy platforming with crazy spikes while being chased by strange eyeball monsters and not getting molested by floor tentacles. I was about to say, this is kind of rude. Hey, do you like blind jumps? You can see little pieces of things that you can grab onto here, but it's still a bit. Tight. Like, I have to fall low enough so that I'm not jumping into the side of this thing here. And then, of course, I need to thread that once I get in. And these tentacles have big, fat hitboxes on either side. Can I touch the thing? I can. That's a surprise. What?! What are you talking about, game? That is something I call bullshit on, for sure. I'm like literally hanging onto the ledge, and I just went up. Now I understand that there are platforms in this game that you can jump through, in which there are spikes on, but then, you know, when you fall back down, then you take damage from the spike, but that wasn't... This was not what occurred. These things are like, oh hey, it's a wall. Oy, oy. Alright. Excuse me, what? Oh. Shit. God damn it. I mean, it's not as though I'm trying to, like, oh man, this game totally screwed me over. I've been playing awesome in this room. But, that one I am going to call out. Yeesh, finally. Okay, so I'm going to need to bounce on this thing's head to regenerate. Oh, what? Oh, right. This thing can actually... actually do the thing. See you, nerd. Okay, so there's a button over there. I can mash into. I've got a little bit of a thing. Maybe not. Thanks, nerd. Oh, that's right, they smash into those. I Sure did. Learn a little bit better, or learn to manipulate these guys a little bit better. Speaking of which, oh no, now I have to drag Theo around. It's the Temple Remix, featuring your boy, Mixmaster Theo. Alright, I have to hold it to carry him, and then I just release and it throws, right? Yeah. Okay. Alright, Theo. I could have sworn I was on that platform when I threw Theo the last time, and he landed in the right spot. Apparently not. Right a little bit. Oh, so I have to say, now that I'm spending, like, a little bit more time with this particular mechanic, I really dislike how in this game you have... Oh god. Give me a second. This isn't canon, is it? What was I going to say? Oh yeah, the slow motion when the enemies approach you. It kind of throws me off on the timing a little bit. Because it feels as though the slow motion kicks in slightly gradually. That's not the worst, but it just... It's like, why is this a thing? Are you kidding? Go away. You guys are the worst. Leave me alone. Jerk. Bopped your noodle. Because, like, I jumped there with a timing that I thought, hey, I'm gonna land on this thing's head, and then it wound up not being the right timing because the game is going in, like, slow motion. started noticing it in some of the more precise areas, it got really annoying. The game freezing every time you dash or pick up a dash refresh or bopping an enemy. Yeah, I know what you mean. Lots of, like, little things. In the main game, it doesn't really retract from anything. But yeah, I mean, obviously these areas are a little bit more on the precise side. I still don't have, like, a really good sense in, like, how far I have to throw Theo. Oh my god, what? What? Hang on. So I can ship him up there, but once I catch him in the air, like, it kills my momentum. Can I dash with Theo in hand? No, I can't. Okay, so then I have to go up here. I have to throw Theo through there. Then we land on this, I can catch him. And then... and then I don't even know what I'm doing with him here. Because if I throw him up here, like, he's just gonna fall down the other side? I mean, I can do this one on my own, like, that's easy enough, but... but I'd need to have Theo up here and then, like, throw him over here. Like, I have to use Theo for this particular purpose. Oh, okay. I just ignore physics by stalling in midair. That's fine. Sure. Why didn't I think of that? Oh, God. Do I... oh, no. Do I really have to do that? I think I do. I hit the button. That is not where I meant for you to end up. Okay. So I think... I was so excited that I actually did the thing. It's just, I'm like, yay! Okay. What? So sometimes I'm hitting the button to pick up Theo, and sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. You're clearly impossible. Oh god. Might be misremembering, you just need to be holding the button to pick him up? Yeah, that's what I was doing. But like, sometimes I would just pass by him in midair and Celeste wouldn't grab him. Okay, so... Okay, so I need to throw Theo, boost over to that thing, probably boost in the air, catch Theo, throw him again. Oh man, this room is going to be a thing. Maybe it's not going to be that much of a thing. Oh, I just needed to grip the thing, dude. What the hell? There we go. Okay. Somehow I get the feeling I'm not... Well, actually... The real question, can I just dump Theo on the left side of the screen and ignore having him with me? I'm guessing no, but I kind of want to explore the room without him. Yeah, the answer is no indeed. Okay. It's okay, it was just easy. Mirror magic. I like that if you don't hit the button here, you just get treated to an infinitely long THX intro. Okay, that's enough of that. Side complete. And we died 105 times. And by we, I mean all of you. That was your fault, not mine. I'm not judging you, though. I'm a really nice guy.